Okay, so God is a many-being thing that chooses a community as its lover, as in the thing it embraces. Because it's many things of spirit, it requires many individuals to inhabit. This is the covenant with the Jews and why it's like a relationship, because God loves them and forgives them like you would a lover. You know, until they just don't care anymore. But God is even better than a person. And all you gotta do is say I'm sorry when he asks. You know how it works. Here's the thing. Everybody wants to fool you into thinking you can change the way you think and feel about it later. Like, yeah, oh yeah, you know this is wrong now, but you can change your mind into loving the new thing. You acclimate the pain and whatever the fuck it is. That is bullshit. The original imprint is the thing. You build from that solid ground. The community is the girl God loves the most, that he wants everyone to know. Therefore, you know.
Yeah, I mean, the thing is, people like Geico because it's easy.
Well.
Car insurance here and home insurance.
Oh,
here.
My God.
Why not? All together.
Okay. Okay.
Geico.
Your life as an individual is the mirror to the aspect of Godhead. Of the aspect of Godhead. That's what makes you a human. This is what separates you from everybody else in the play of things. That's why you feel special. But to get, that's the big trick. That's why they tell you you're worthy, because you want to hear that. You're actually waiting for it. But it's only your lover who can tell you that. That's the member of the community who can tell you you're worthy. Like the saying, I don't need you to tell me I'm a man, I have a woman to do that. That's where that comes from. Why that's a thing. Think of the rough parts of the Bible as somebody cheating on somebody. Like Sodom and Gomorrah is infidelity. And also an affinity to things that are... It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. You gotta understand, the sexual aspects of the Bible are completely overlooked in modern Christianity, which is why it's a dead religion. The path, they don't want, as far as I can tell, what they don't want people to know is that you're on the same path. It's not a thing in the past. It's a process that everybody's going through. The only thing you can do is deny that. Or choose. Here's the trick. Is they want you to think that you can choose a different process.
which there is only one process. It's just, Okay. Wheat from chaff requires an intelligence to separate them. The plant just grows them together. The urge to look at life and feel like there's something to do comes from that process. You separate meat from bone, you separate the fruit from the plant. But that is as far as much as you need to do other than tend the garden. The be here now thing is what Allison was just saying. It. The world looks like chaos, but the center of it is the perfection. It's not like we're trying to build perfection. That's the image we have deep inside that makes us feel like we need to do something around us. But what we need to do is understand ourselves, and that the outside is a reflection of the inside. The reason I'm always talking about Legacy of Kain and shit like that is because of the multiple forces manipulating. Okay, because it's like in the Bible, where there's a name, a person, that represents an entire species or bloodline or family. Okay, like the Cain and Abel can be looked at as tribes of men. But, where are we going? Round and round. Going round and round. Ah! Pussifer.
Pussifer. Enjoy.
Enjoy. Oh yeah, I got my shit right here. I don't gotta think about this.
Pups of the Dog Star. I probably already did read this shit. Oh, okay. That might be good. I don't even know what this is. Who wrote it?
50 with a 40. What's your 20, honey? Papa's all alone. Empty hizzy left me dizzy. I'm a pirate, lost his booty. I'm a pimp without a dog, without a bone. Okay. Shit, do I want to talk about? Yeah, okay. So Cain is soul or mind. Raziel is both body and spirit, or pneuma. Cain mediates between the two. That's why he's represented as the body who wields the sword. Das Kane. Okay. No, it's like an arcade. Weird one for me to pull out. But it's unsullied by other people talking shit about it. So I have no competition. Which is my favorite kind. Yeah, oh, fucking hell. The first game is spent getting armor for Kane. Before he ever gets the Reaver. Wow, along the way. But the body cannot live without the mind, and vice versa. That's the whole fucking one of the first lessons in the Matrix. So before they even know it, Kane and Raziel are bound to each other. This is the big thing. This is why I talk about Hilden and ancient vampires, because as far as I can tell, they are analogs for Arum and Lucifer intelligences. Luciferian. Angelic. The angelic. I kind of lump in. I keep lumping in Luciferian and angelic, which I guess Luciferian would be a third of the angelic, right? A third would have ascended completely. Okay, you're right. Anyway. There's only a... Okay. You are on a quest. You put yourself on the quest. Called life. There is not... There is a right and a wrong way to do things, but it's incorrect to say that there's a right and a wrong way to do things. Because things are constantly changing. Except for things that are right and wrong. Which sounds like you constantly do the same thing and you'll be alright. Which is kind of true. But it doesn't allow for progress. So, humans start out as babies. And it's like, yeah, that's how life works. But life is the thing that's set in motion that everyone's trying to find a beginning to without considering the setting in motion. It's just like the universe itself. We can mathematically go back to a point where it's like, yeah, it started exploding out from this point. But who lit them? Who set it off? There is always a thing that precedes all of the math that we base everything off of. And that's because we're removing a crucial element, a factor infinite and unknown. And everybody seems to do this in their work. Wow, almost everybody. This is a corruption in the mind at a fundamental level, though. In the game, it is described as a lover is murdered of the mind guardian. person they kill is the Balance Guardian, infecting the future Balance Guardian with the corruption instilled by the murder. It's orchestrated madness. And a liar. Cooperate or cheat. Signal error results in tit for tat. kind of does it. No kitty, bad kitty. No kitty. That's good. No.
Change has not come to destroy. Mutations take time to reveal their true purpose in nature. We speak of evolution a lot, but rarely of the evolution of the senses, from touch to sight. As the body evolves, so too society. Family will pervade all through the machine. Family will pervade all through the machine. Same as always. But everyone will know where they stand and why. A return to the beginning. But the amount of need is so great. There is no need to favor Abel over Cain. To each their own. Those who bear good fruit, bear good fruit. Those who do not, do not. Let the appetite of each decide. Feast or famine. Fruit or and or flesh. The ability to live in Zion is available to all. Bound to the Matrix. It is as always, as it always has been, a problem of choice. A once unconscious choice is now given to all throughout life. No rescue per se. Like the story of the kid, we must self-substantiate. Join the circus, run faster than the limit, see the code for what it is. Free your mind. Upgrading the Matrix is now beyond the war program. The one containing the code is now hidden among the people. No rescue means no need to seek out a the savior. And that's my cup. Morning. Morty. Where was it? However, the Prime Program upgrade is still needed from the One. The One is and has always been the community of the elect. And carry the light transmission together. This alludes to the co-creation of humanity with spirit or the machines, upgrading the Matrix together. All living links to the source. The great liberation and total control come simultaneously, for only when humanity gives itself completely will order reign supreme. But this order will only come at the onset of total freedom. No shame, no fear, nothing to hide. Only rapists and murderers. This list is obviously a bit longer. Larger? Morty, you're gonna fucking get it. Anyway, these are the only ones that have anything to fear. And Morty. Morty should be afraid. He's not. Bad kitty. No kitty, bad kitty. Run away from him. Asshole. My fault. He shouldn't have had a cup sitting there with what looks to be paint water in it. What was I thinking? Their kinks or addiction will stand in the way of someone being themselves. The self-wound of mankind will heal itself. I can't finish it. Human body is a tool, an information collecting device within the matrix around you. The world you see is a mirror to your body. as in you see what is useful to you. Feel drawn to it. Light needs darkness to shine within. What else could it? Yeah. Inside, outside, upside down. Okay.
Does it see it? Nobody knows what you can see.
Numa, spirit. I can't read. Soul, consciousness, intelligence, being, soma. Many divisions of things we call one thing. That's where we get mixed up. Because the divisions show where we're connected. The highest is within the lowest. As in, the body controlled by the mind uses everything it does is spirit, but it's perceived as it using something very physical to do so, a la the sword. It is in the we can just skip the whole story and talk about it at the end. The reason Cain doesn't need the heart inside of him is because Raziel healed him after Raziel himself ripped the heart out. But in this painting, Raziel's already a part of Cain. Cain's ripping his own heart out and offering it because this is after Cain. Okay, Cain is a fatalist. He believes in determinism as much as the Elder God does. So when he sees things in the timeline, he doesn't do anything different. He just feels different when he does them. As in, when he throws Raziel into the abyss, he doesn't do it out of jealousy for getting wings. He does it because he did it before. And what's happened, happened, and couldn't happen any other way, according to Cain. He believes that Raziel can choose to change things and wants to facilitate his becoming his true self. But it's comes back around that Raziel shows Cain that he can make his own choices, but this happens only by Cain being healed by the purified Reaver and Raziel. Like, Raziel purifies himself. Because there's, I want to make a, these are supposed to be a mirror. That's why I wanted it to be like this. Because I was going to have Raziel, one of Raziel and one of Cain. And, I couldn't get the arm pointed out, so I just made it. If it fits the tree better like this. Anyway. Oh. But like everything else, these are stories about a process that you can undergo. These are
the people that wrote these stories clearly knew enough about symbolism to put some... Here's the great and terrible truth of reality, is that people that make things don't have to understand what they make, to be driven to make them. The ideas they have and put down will make sense to you the way it's supposed to. That's the hidden language, is that everything is talking to you. That's why it's a good idea to clean up around you so that you limit the information coming in. Control it as much as you can, because it's overwhelming. The light transmission is overwhelming. That's why the levels of gray, that you would not make it to the light had you go straight from dark to light. Nothing would survive. That's why the seasons gradually go. And that's why there's places of the earth that are constantly in the sun, balanced by places that are constantly cold. Relatively. It's all relative, but extremes exist. So that we know, here's the thing, they're not two different things. It is one thing. There isn't good and bad. There is expression. There is corruption, putrefaction, and rebirth. The things that embrace those aspects are those things. Or at least represent avatars of those things. And it's not as much as that you can choose, it's that you recognize what you are and you move it towards spirit or towards self, because everything can be connected to spirit in a sense. But then everything can turn, see, here's I almost contradict myself, because I'm saying you could turn in on yourself away from spirit, but actually turning into yourself is towards spirit. You can embrace this broken facade, an image that you see darkly in a mirror, that you then build more towards that image. You're like, you see yourself as a monster in the mirror, and so you embrace the image. And then when light shines on you more, you see more like that. Or you see that in the image, and you recognize what to take away, or limit, or transform. My spirit is fire, it transforms everything.
Pun Numa? Time and space matrix transcended to flesh of new self. Fully aware universe made in the womb of our mother. To repeat the same pattern on a higher level of being. Beyond all we know and are yet made completely of us. Oh, that's what this is. That's why there's two of them. This represents the inner world of ego, intellect, imagination within the body, the psyche, and the spirit. And then the Malkuth, find Soma, being, ego, intelligence, consciousness, soul, spirit, Numa. That then goes up. It's a tree of life. It's a tree of life with Klippoth, Malkuth going into Klippoth of the mind. That's why in the Matrix movie, it's the mind that they're having. All the action in the movie The Matrix is conversations happening within the mind of the people. The weapons they use or the fighting style they use is this, the way they communicate. This is why the one can stop bullets. It's like shutting people the fuck up. Shut the fuck up.
When the levee breaks.
No orgies or banquets, only late night TV. Woe to the masses of the 21st century. All sealed in slippery plastics and organized in little boxes. With. What? All tethered in place, wired together with iron and rubber, suspended by steel. Behold the civilized human race, a carnival of confusion where clowns run the show, lions below the tightrope with freak show comprised of mirrors pointed towards you. Man-made maladies. What? Man-made maladies. Moderate more mandates, making mankind more Machiavellian. Moreover, our attitude toward unity is unnerving. I gotta read that again. Man-made maladies motivate more mandates, making mankind more Machiavellian. Moreover, our attitude toward unity is unnerving. Cringe kills the mood, a feeling, the game. Cringe is the weapon mass destroying all in its way. How cringe is the here and now. Wow. Wait. How cringe is the here and now. Wow. It's all really happening. Happy with or disappointed? Run down and tired, or are you still motivated? Helpful and hopeful, honored human, hear hallelujah. Be as you are. As seen by yourself within. Our joy is to see your joy. Vicarious vestiges. I stopped. I must have forgot I was about. He got busy. I'm gonna mark that. I remember. Vicarious vestiges. Veiling. Veiling. No. We won't write together. That's silly. That's another guy altogether. Oh, here we go. Maybe this is the one.
Unable to. Oh, whatever.
Yeah.
Surrender.
A group of travelers reach a temple built into the mountainside. The travelers had followed a path they found by the river, in the valley near their home. A man was there cutting wood for a fire, on which he boiled water. Oh no, this isn't done. No. I'll start it, because whatever. The time's going to cut out anyway, but I didn't work this out. I remember this. Maybe you can help. Boiled water. The water rose as a vapor that moved through. No. I'm not. Nope. It gets too weird. I get numbers. Nobody wants to do numbers. Not right now. Sun's not up yet. Entropy corrupted by order. A light within the dark. Mind emitting matter. Flesh for feeling, eyes for sight. The purifying cauldron. Primordial ancient soup. Pan's sperm impacts the surface deep within the womb. Solar flares. Fireworks in mysterious ways. Mutation maintaining change. It is stability. Mating marine mitosis. Genetic engineers building forms for functions. Unaware for what or where, but each knows where to put it. If not, they end up food. A mighty mouth that hungers. Integration through digestion. Assimilation of piece to whole. Information transfer requires energy, light, and heat. Think of the sun. It is the way it is as a metaphor, and literally, it gives life to this world in conjunction with the Earth, Moon, and other planets, filtering the light and reflecting it back. All stars too reach us. Billions of years ago, billions upon billions of stars sung their song, or held their note, and over time, the sonnet of the universe tuned into itself and condenses and evaporates simultaneously everywhere throughout time and space. If you are aware, hear now, be aware and be aware. Be aware and beware. Strange are all mysteries. If you can't remember all you have forgotten, how can you be sure of who you really are? Beware and beware, stranger, all mysteries. Forecasts upholding the great illusion by playing for money and success, hoping you can win. Sanya, stop. I can't say words. One who leaves the game of life and lives in the forest. Buddha was the son of a king because one must have it in order to truly give it up. Desire to obtain and all the vices and pitfalls involved hinder the progress. To walk the path requires a lot of up and downs, which can take time. Offered the ability to anything, all the world and its treasures, at your fingertips. All the knowledge written and recorded throughout history. The best music, food, entertainment, and games. What would you choose? Honestly. All drugs, women and men, boys and girls, willing or not. All to please. You. Would you walk the path? A path no one but you can walk, for it is internal. Holy astral mountain of madness, mocking your every step, every decision debated, though you know the right choice. Temptation test leading with laziness.
The serpent holds what God needs. God has what the serpent desires. Do not feel the need to drop out. Dissolution is a process requiring no will. Tune into the resonance. Simply allow yourself to fall into place. The living ship of Theseus, attempting to understand its true nature, but stranger still, a copy without an original. Time distorts all messages. Every truth is subject to change. Aurora Borealis. Dream work, interpreting my... Oh, it's a title. It's a title to what I'm looking at. Had reoccurring dreams where I was a serpent eating itself. I was hungry. The most intense hunger filled my full awareness. Also in my awareness was a mouth. To do anything but be hungry, I had to eat. It was a lot like breathing. More than chewing my tail or toes, it was just like when you are trapped underwater and then you get out and take a breath. That kind of relief. So to ease my suffering or longing or hunger, I continue to consume and grow. I become a perfect being, self-contained, self-satisfied, but ultimately by myself. Eventually, this relief turns to joy, which turns orgasmic, which wakes me. I continue having this experience or dream as a dragon or serpent, but eventually I have a dream that somehow leads to this experience. But it's achieved by me, as above, belowing myself. After this, I have reoccurring dreams where I alternate from Ouroboros to me. At times it seems like my legs up to my waist are in my mouth. Then I'll gain awareness of my legs. But always the spasm wakes me up. I always resist finishing in an Ouroboros form. Or any form, really. As myself, I grew to resist the act altogether. Eventually, the dream stopped coming with such frequency. Monolithic Ouroboros information. Ancient symbol, archetype of the collective unconscious. The circle, self-contained, pre-conscious. There was something formless yet complete that existed before heaven and earth, without sound, without substance, dependent on nothing, unchanging, all-pervading, unfailing. One may think of it as the mother of all things under heaven. Atman. God symbolizing unity by self-realizing as a whole divided to two. Ion. See, I had a bunch of shit written here. You don't know where it was. So that was basically that was a dream I was having for a while where I was, I was belowing myself is what eventually turned into. And I eventually was able to pull my head out of it. Like, literally stand up is how one of the last dreams ended. Evolutionary stage of ego. Tomb, cave, house, womb. Matriarchal home, great mother. Alex Grace, fetus skull, digestion, consuming, assimilation of unconscious, that which embraces. Embraces? It's all scripty. Appropriate as a symbol of organization? You don't know how to spell. And create a phenomenon too. And not only in the religious phenomenon, the life-spanning figure of the round signifies the regenerative sea and the source of higher life. Oh, I think this is about the circle. Or the Ouroboros still. Yeah. Ouroboric incest cleaving to the mother. Inward digestion is to possess and obtain power. Conscious realization is eating in this sense.
conscious mind assimilating unconscious aspects or newly found knowledge. Yeah, there was something about eating is a form of obtaining energy unconsciously. You don't understand it, but you process it into energy. Your stomach understands. Well, some of it. You shit most of it out.
But must surrender. Can you go to the vision that's in my head, taking it back to the start of your life? So delighted with a new understanding, something about the little evil that makes that unmistakable noise I was hearing, the unmistakable sound that I know so well. Spitting, sweating with the look in your face.
Oh shit, look at this. The wound of I can't say his name. Amorphatus. You know, the king. Self-wound. What does it say? The snake is a symbol of phallic fertility. Leviathan, dragon of avarice, are monstrous abominations of this force. Hermes is god in the... Hermes? What? The gods? What? In the mind and the soul... Oh, God is in the mind. The mind is in the soul is in the meta. All things by eternity. All this universal body, in which is all bodies, is full of soul. The soul is full of mind, and the mind full of God. Or, fuck, this is all scribbled. Yeah, of God throughout the great year, as we descend on the lower ages, the soul will wear many different garments and will walk many different paths, each path testing the soul for its worth while it is housed in its material shell, partaking in the creative experience. Struggle with self, for the serpent is a positive and negative image. Struggle with self, for the serpent is a positive and negative image. Yormagon. Yormagon? Your man gone. Your man gone? Goddamn right he is when I come around. Double-edged sword of knowledge. No reward, no punishment. One chooses what form to take based on one's desires. Life is judgment and reward. To each his own. Seek the beginning to know the end. Knowledge of death can free you from its despair. Yeah, I think I wrote this part. The Prince Pie of Rhythm? When the fuck did I write this? I said the sword's a phallic image, right? That's obvious, right? The multiplicity arises from the division of the one, divided to its smallest point and set loose to rebuild from there. Conflict at one level is health at another. Entropy enters order, chaos brings news. Brings new life from putrefaction. There are no mistakes, even the mistakes made. This paradox is key to gnosis, for it exposes the nature of evil, i.e., that which is not good, and in fact opposes it willfully, thus shining a light on what good is. Balance involvement and a detachment. Control the noise generated by your mind. Allow yourself to feel fear and shame in the moment, but also let it pass into conscious awareness and control. Be not afraid of false evidence appearing real. imagined. Dragons of the past and future can do you no harm unless you imagine they do. Be here now. Endure yourself as yourself. You may find you actually like it.
Nice.
I know this is silly, and it exposes my madness. But keeping it inside is killing me. For as long as I can remember, I have had dreams of being with a girl watching fireworks. It's 4th of July, and I'm visiting my father. He and my stepmother are in the car, and I'm sitting on the ground on a hill watching the light show. That's enough of that. We've been over that. Many-breasted, many-veiled daughters of Zeus. Fireworks go off, she looks different. This is the thing in the book of all. That's what I was saying about your lover can tell you who you are because they tell you who they are. Nui in the book of the law says, I will reveal myself to you by a secret name which I have given him to him. But that's talking about your lover revealing themselves to you. Because you, as much as conquest is written into the stories of guys getting a woman, it's her who chooses you. Like, even in Sleeping Beauty, she puts a call out at the beginning for him to come, and they see each other for a second, and then she's put to sleep, and then he's still compelled to find her because she called for him.
It's far too late, it says.
Not having sex is no fun unless I do it for you. I'm well aware of how crazy I sound, but to me, you are the grail. Sorry, or you're welcome. Both. I think that's a letter. I'm reading a letter.